Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So this is the introductory video on the analog and the digital communication, and we will see some basic terminologies and the basic block diagram of the communication system. So in a very basic sense, the communication is the exchange of information between the two points. And in an electronics point of view, using the electronic gadgets and the devices, the information can be exchanged between the two points which are far away from each other. So this exchange of information could be wired or the wireless. And the communication could be point-to-point communication or point-to-multipoint, or even it could be in the network also. And many times, this communication could be even the broadcast also, where from one station, the information is broadcasted. And one such example is the FM transmission, where a radio station broadcasts the information at a particular frequency, and anyone can tune their receiver to the particular frequency or the channel to receive the information. And in fact, using the gadgets, we are sending and receiving the information every day. Like talking on a smartphone or sending an email to someone, and even watching the television are the examples of the different communication system. So through a basic block diagram of the communication system, let us understand how the information is exchanged between the two points. So in this block diagram, the first block is the source itself, from where the message signal is generated. So this message could be voice, email or the television signal, or it could be even some data signal. So if this message is in non-electric form, then using the transducer, it is converted into the electrical signal. So the microphone, CCD camera and the computer keyboard are the examples of the transducer. For example, using the microphone, our voice can be converted into the electrical signal. And using the camera, the picture or the motion can be converted into the digital signal. So after this transducer, the electrical signal which we have is known as the input signal. Then after this transducer, the next block is the transmitter. So this transmitter modifies the input signal for the efficient transmission. And this transmitter module also contains several subsystems, like the modulator, the analog to digital converter and the encoder. And many times it also contains the amplifier system. For example, if the signal is analog in nature and it needs to be converted into the digital form, then first it is sampled at the regular intervals and then it is quantized. And after the quantization, using the analog to digital converter, it is converted into the digital form. And later, it can be encoded in a particular format using the encoder. And usually, for the efficient transmission, the signal is modulated using the particular scheme. So this modulation is the process where the property of the periodic signal, like the amplitude, phase or the frequency, is altered according to the input signal. And of course, in the upcoming videos, we will talk in detail about this modulation. So anyway, these are the some of the subsystems of this transmitter module. Now, when we talk about the transmitted signal, then we need to know certain characteristics of this transmitted signal, like whether it is analog or the digital signal. What is the frequency of the signal? If it contains multiple frequencies, then what is the range of frequencies in the transmitted signal? Or in other way, what is the bandwidth of the transmitted signal? And if the signal is transmitted in the digital form, then at which rate the data is transmitted? Or in other words, what is the data rate or the bit rate of the transmitted signal? Then another important aspect is the power level of the signal, because that will decide how long the signal can be transmitted over a particular medium faithfully. So these are the some of the aspects which are very important for the transmitted signal. And one needs to see these aspects while designing the communication link. So the signal after this transmitter is known as the transmitted signal. And this signal is sent over the particular channel. So a channel is the medium over which the signal is transmitted over the certain distance. So this channel could be a physical channel like an optical fiber or the coaxial cable, or it could be a wireless channel like a radio link. So this channel partly behaves like a filter and attenuates the different frequencies of the transmitted signal differently. So once the transmitted signal passes through the channel and gets received at the receiver, then it gets attenuated as well as the distorted. Moreover, the noise also gets superimposed over the transmitted signal. So if this is the transmitted signal at the transmitter end, then at the receiver, we may receive the attenuated as well as the distorted signal. And by what amount the signal will get attenuated and the distorted will depend on the length of the channel. So if the signal travels longer in a particular medium, then the attenuation and the distortion of the signal will be more. But the detector or the receiver should be able to recover the message signal from this distorted signal. And whether the detector is able to recover the signal or not, it depends on the signal to noise ratio. So it is a very important parameter in the communication system. So this parameter is the ratio of the signal power to the noise power. So by increasing the signal power, the signal to noise ratio can be improved and the signal can be transmitted over a longer distance faithfully. Now many times, the signal needs to be transmitted over a much longer distance and it is not possible to increase the signal power beyond the certain limit. So in such case, regenerative repeaters are used after the certain distance. So these regenerative repeaters detects the distorted and the noisy signal and generates the fresh copy of the transmitted signal. And that signal is once again transmitted over the particular channel. So this is another way to increase the distance over which the signal can be transmitted. Apart from that, for the digital signals, using the error correction mechanism and by adding the redundancy in the message signal, the error in the received signal can be reduced. So for a transmitting medium or a channel perspective, following are the important specifications. The first is, what is the length of the channel or a distance over which the signal can be transmitted faithfully. Then another important specification is the bandwidth of the channel. So it is the range of the frequencies which is supported by the channel with reasonable fidelity. For example, if a particular channel can transmit the signal in the range of 0 to 20 kHz, then we can say that the bandwidth of the channel is 20 kHz. And if the signal is transmitted in the digital form, then for the digital signal, the another important aspect is the data rate. That is the maximum supported data rate by the particular channel. So these are the some of the important aspects for the channel perspective. Now at the receiver, this received signal is demodulated. And if the signal is in digital form, then first of all it is decoded and then using the digital to analog converter, it is converted into the analog signal. And after the proper amplification, this signal is given to the output transducer. So this output transducer could be a speaker or it could be even a display screen of the smartphone or the monitor. So this is the basic block diagram of the communication system and a little overview of how the information or the message is transmitted from one point to the another point. So in the upcoming videos, we will see how to represent the signal using the Fourier series and the Fourier transform. And then we will also talk about the different modulation schemes. And in the digital communication, we will also see how the analog signal can be digitized and the encoded. So we will discuss about the source coding. Then we will discuss about some multiplexing schemes. And we'll also see different error correction mechanisms which is used in the communication. So these are the some of the topics we will discuss in the upcoming videos. But I hope in this video, you got the basic overview of the analog and the digital communication. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.